On a quiet Friday, just before lunch on March 28, 2025, the city of Mandalay in central Myanmar was shattered by a sudden convulsion of the earth. In an instant, the ground heaved violently, buildings swayed and cracked, and a powerful magnitude 7.7 earthquake erupted along Myanmar's infamous Sagaing Fault. Panicked residents fled into the streets as centuries-old pagodas crumbled and modern apartments pancaked. This was Myanmar's strongest quake in over a century, unleashing devastation not just in Myanmar, but even toppling a high-rise under construction in Bangkok, Thailand, nearly 1,300 kilometers away. The disaster left over 1,600 people dead in Myanmar and thousands injured, with dozens more fatalities in neighboring Thailand. In the quake's aftermath, a haunting question loomed. Could another massive earthquake strike again soon? To answer that, we need to journey into the science of how this earthquake happened and explore whether the geological forces beneath Myanmar and South Asia are primed for a repeat performance. But before we dive into the future, make sure to subscribe to our channel for more cool and informative videos like this one. And don't forget to hit the bell icon so you'll know when a new one crops up. It was just past 12:50 PM local time when the earthquake hit, centered near the Sagaing Mandalay region of Myanmar. The rupture tore along the Sagaing Fault, a major crack in the earth that runs under Myanmar, with the crust on either side sliding past in opposite directions. In geology terms, this was a strike-slip quake, the same style as California's famous San Andreas Fault, where two blocks of crust grind laterally against each other. The shock was shallow, about 10 kilometers deep, meaning the shaking at the surface was especially intense. In Mandalay, Myanmar's second largest city close to the epicenter, residents described the ground motion like a giant wrestling the city. A rescue worker from a suburb of Mandalay said, "Our town looks like a collapsed city," estimating a fifth of the buildings were destroyed. Within minutes, iconic infrastructure lay in ruins. The historic Ava Bridge over the Irrawaddy River had crumbled into the water. Roads ripped apart and power lines were down. The human toll was harrowing. In Myanmar, over 1,600 lives were lost and more than 3,000 people were injured amid the wreckage. It was the country's deadliest earthquake since 1930. Entire neighborhoods were reduced to rubble piles and desperate search efforts unfolded as day turned to night. The disaster struck at the worst possible time for Myanmar, a nation already grappling with a civil conflict and limited resources for emergency response. The chaos was compounded by disrupted communications. Phone and internet networks went down, cutting off affected towns. Hospitals, still standing, overflowed with the injured. Yet the shock waves did not stop at Myanmar's borders. Astonishingly, the quake's tremors rippled through the ground and were felt in 57 provinces of Thailand, as well as in parts of China, India, and Bangladesh. In Bangkok, nearly 1,000 kilometers away, high-rise buildings shook long enough to send people running out in panic. Some in nothing but bathrobes after evacuating rooftop pools when water began sloshing over the edges. One 33-story skyscraper under construction in Bangkok collapsed entirely, killing at least 8 workers and trapping dozens under concrete and twisted steel. The Myanmar-Thailand earthquake of 2025 was a grim reminder of the forces our planet can unleash. But what exactly caused this quake and why here? To understand that, we must peer beneath the surface of Myanmar, into the slow-motion drama of colliding tectonic plates that had been building up to this very rupture. To grasp how this earthquake happened, picture the Earth's outer layer as a giant jigsaw puzzle of rigid pieces, called tectonic plates. These plates fit together like puzzle pieces, but they are not static. They creep and grind against each other, moving at mere centimeters per year atop the softer, hot mantle beneath. Over years and centuries, that motion generates immense stress along the plate boundaries. An earthquake is what we feel when that pent-up energy suddenly releases and the plates lurch past each other, causing the ground to shake. In many ways, it's like pulling a spring or a rubber band until it snaps. The pressure builds slowly and then releases violently. Myanmar happens to lie at a very busy juncture in the tectonic puzzle. In fact, this country is squeezed between 4 major plates: the Indian plate, the Eurasian plate, the Sunda plate, and the Burma microplate, all jostling for position. The Indian subcontinent, in particular, is on a geological collision course with Asia, driving northward at about 5 centimeters per year, roughly the speed your fingernails grow. Like a relentless slow-motion car crash, this colossal convergence is the force that raised the Himalayan mountains, and it's the ultimate driver of many South Asian earthquakes. In Myanmar's case, much of the Indian plate's push is deflected sideways. As India slams into Eurasia, a chunk of crust, the Burma plate, is being shoved northward and eastward, slithering past the Sunda plate to the south. Nature has accommodated this sideways slip by slicing a huge tear through Myanmar's crust, the Sagaing Fault. This fault is a nearly straight line running about 1,200 kilometers from north to south through Myanmar. Essentially, it's a giant crack in the earth, marking where the land west of the fault on the India-Burma plate side slides north relative to the land east of the fault on the Sunda plate side. The two sides of the Sagaing Fault grind past each other at a rate of up to 18 to 49 millimeters per year, an eye-opening pace in geologic terms. If that motion were smooth, we'd just get slow, creeping movement. But the crust is sticky and strong, so the fault remains locked for decades or centuries, even as stress builds up inexorably. When the force can no longer be contained, the fault ruptures in a sudden slip. That's the earthquake. Geologists compare the Sagaing Fault's role to California's San Andreas Fault, and for good reason. Both are long transform, side-slipping, faults capable of very large earthquakes. The straightness of the Sagaing Fault is a worrying trait. It means a rupture can run very far once it gets going, producing a bigger quake. In 2025, that is exactly what happened. The Sagaing Fault unzipped for some 350 to 500 kilometers in a matter of minutes during the Myanmar quake. Imagine the earth ripping open along a path the length of a few entire countries, with one side of the ground jerking up to 6 meters, about 20 feet, relative to the other. Such was the power released on that March afternoon. The ground shook at violent MMI 9 intensity near the rupture, enough to pulverize buildings. But the United States Geological Surveys estimate nearly 22 million people in Myanmar experienced strong shaking, at least MMI 5, during this event. The Sagaing Fault has been the culprit behind Myanmar's most destructive quakes for centuries, running through or very close to major cities like Yangon, Naypyidaw, and Mandalay. It puts millions of people directly in harm's way. History shows the fault's deadly potential. Large earthquakes struck in 1930, twice near Bago, 1931, 1946, 1956, and as recently as 2012, all with magnitudes around 7 or greater. In each case, the Earth likely remained stuck for decades until strain overcame the friction. Scientists who study the Sagaing Fault have identified segments that tend to break separately, each with its own recurrence interval, roughly how often it produces a big quake. For example, the southern portion of the fault near Yangon last ruptured in 1930 and appears to have a return period on the order of 100 to 150 years. That hints that parts of the fault near Myanmar's biggest city could be building toward another event within this century. A chilling prospect for Yangon's 5 plus million residents. Intriguingly, researchers had long flagged that central stretch as a seismic gap, an area along the fault that hadn't ruptured in a long time and was likely accumulating strain. A 2011 study pointed out two significant gaps on Sagaing, one in central Myanmar between about 19.2 degrees north and 21.5 degrees north, covering the Myitla region, and another at the fault's far southern end, south of 16.6 degrees north into the Andaman Sea. The central gap was capable of a magnitude 7.9 earthquake if it broke fully, researchers estimated. Now in 2025, it appears a large portion of that central segment did finally break. But what about the other identified gap to the far south? That section of the fault, partly offshore in the Andaman Sea, hasn't popped in recent history. Could it be the next to go? It's natural to wonder if another massive quake might strike again, perhaps even in the near future, especially as aftershocks continue to rattle nerves. Indeed, the Myanmar quake sequence included more than 70 aftershocks, one as large as magnitude 6.7 just 12 minutes after the main shock. These aftershocks will taper off with time, but they remind us that the Earth's crust is still adjusting. However, a repeat of the exact same 7.7 quake on the same fault segment is unlikely in the immediate future. That segment has just released its stress and will take time many decades at least, to reload. The more relevant concern is whether adjacent segments or other faults might rupture next. Large earthquakes can sometimes transfer stress to nearby fault sections, effectively bringing them closer to their breaking point. It's as if one section of a stuck zipper gave way, and the stress concentration moves to the still locked section further along the zipper. Geologists don't have a crystal ball to predict when the next big quake will happen. It could be tomorrow or decades away, but they can identify zones that are ripe with strain. In Myanmar, other parts of the Sagaing Fault remain locked and dangerous. The southern Sagaing Gap, toward the Andaman Sea, is one candidate, having been quiet for a long time. Rupture there could threaten southern Myanmar and even trigger tsunamis if it slips under the seafloor. And to the north, the fault runs towards the eastern Himalaya. Portions of the far northern Sagaing Fault saw major quakes in the 1940s, but if any segments up there have been skipping their turn, they too could be prone to a future jolt. The bottom line is that as long as the tectonic plates keep pushing, and they will, stress will continue to accumulate on all these faults. Another earthquake akin to the 2025 event will occur in this region. The pressing question is, when? Seismologists often talk in terms of probabilities over decades, because pinpointing quakes in advance remains beyond our reach. However, some worrying signs have drawn attention. In the months leading up to the Myanmar quake, locals noted an uptick in small tremors. In fact, 8 minor quakes shook parts of Myanmar in just the first week of March 2025. Promoting public concern. Neighboring Bangladesh also recorded an unusual flurry of small quakes. According to Bangladeshi experts, the frequency of tremors was rising in early 2025, which they cautioned could be a warning sign of a larger event in the pipeline. The implication is clear. The 2025 Myanmar quake might not be an isolated freak event, but part of a broader pattern of strain release in the region. Myanmar is not alone in facing the threat of powerful earthquakes. The entire region where the Indian plate collides with its neighbors, from the Himalayas down through Myanmar and into Indonesia, is one of the most seismic active belts on Earth. Geologists call it the Alpide Belt, and it has produced catastrophic quakes throughout history. For instance, just to the northwest of Myanmar lies the Himalaya Range, under which the Indian plate is diving beneath Eurasia along a giant crack called the main Himalayan thrust. This is the source of Nepal and North India's big quakes. In April 2015, Nepal experienced a magnitude 7.8 Gorkha earthquake that killed around 9,000 people when a section of this fault ruptured near Kathmandu. That quake didn't release all the built-up stress. In fact, parts of the Himalayan fault further west haven't ruptured in centuries. Geoscientists worry about a known seismic gap in western Nepal. There hasn't been a major quake recorded there since 1505, over 500 years ago. This means that another great Himalayan quake, possibly even larger than 2015, is essentially inevitable in the future. It's not a matter of if, but when. Looking south and east, Bangladesh and northeast India sit at another dangerous junction of plates. Bangladesh lies just east of where the Indian plate grinds under the Burma plate. Along the coast of Myanmar and Bangladesh runs the Sunda megathrust, the same plate boundary that further south caused the 2004 Sumatra-Andaman magnitude 9.1 quake and tsunami, and which in 1762 unleashed an estimated M8.5 quake off the Arakan-Rakhine coast. An earthquake on that offshore fault could send devastating shaking into coastal Bangladesh and Myanmar, and potentially generate tsunamis in the Bay of Bengal. And what about Thailand and the rest of Southeast Asia? Thailand doesn't sit directly on a plate boundary like Myanmar does, which means huge quakes are rarer there. But as the 2025 event proved, distance is no guarantee of safety. Bangkok's high-rises, built on soft, swampy soil, wobbled dramatically from a quake 1,000 kilometers away. The soft clay beneath the city amplified the distant seismic waves, making tall buildings sway for a long time. Many older structures in Bangkok were never designed with earthquakes in mind. Seismic building codes only came into effect there in the past few decades. This is a concern because if a closer quake strikes, say in western Thailand or along the Thai-Myanmar border, the damage in Bangkok could be far worse. So, can another earthquake like Myanmar's strike again soon? The science tells us yes. Not necessarily in the exact same spot, but elsewhere along the restless plate boundaries of Myanmar and its neighbors. The tectonic tension is indeed always building, day by day, millimeter by millimeter. When and where it will next unleash a devastating quake is uncertain, but several candidates loom on the horizon. Perhaps a locked stretch of the Sagaing Fault to the south, or a long-dormant segment of the Himalayan megathrust, or an active fault near a major city like Dhaka. In all these places, the ground is under strain, like a wound-up spring waiting to snap. Scientists monitor these faults, map past ruptures, and use GPS to measure the slow movements, trying to read the Earth's subtle warning signs. Lastly, it's worth remembering that earthquakes, while destructive, are a natural part of our planet's ceaseless evolution. The same forces that tear down buildings also built the magnificent Himalayas and created the landscapes we live on. We cannot stop the Earth's plates from moving, but we can study and respect them. The March 2025 Myanmar earthquake was a dramatic chapter in the story of a restless Earth. Could another chapter be written soon? Geology gives us an uneasy answer. Very possibly, yes. In the end, the question isn't if another earthquake like Myanmar's will strike. It's whether we will be ready when it does. So, do you think an earthquake in the future is inevitable? Let us know what you think in the comments below.